Hey everybody, today we're going to go over upgrading a FortiGate. If you're new here, I'm Gregabyte and I talk all things network and security. So I was logging into my FortiGate the other day and noticed that it needed an upgrade, so I thought I'd take you all along with me. So right here, it'll just add you back into the FortiGate setup, and we see that upgrade firmware is the only thing left to do. So we'll hit begin. It will give us the version that we're currently on and the version we should move to. We can even click on the release notes, which I highly recommend. I've already gone through and checked all of these different things, made sure that nothing really big was going to impact me. So we're going to review firmware upgrade. And the big thing here is that you can see that 7.0.15 is a mature release, which means that we're not going to see really added features or removed features, which is something you can see inside of here as well. We've only got a new command in here, just some more support for QNQ. And then just another note about FortiGate Cloud now being something that you have to pay for if you want to have read-write access. So inside of here, we're going to click on my firewall and we'll hit upgrade. Then on here again, we still have the release notes, security fabric upgrade notes, and I am okay with that. So we'll click on that and then we're going to confirm and backup config. There you go. Now you can see it. It'll just require us to verify that we're okay with a reboot. We'll hit OK or continue. We'll see that we got a backup up there, and we'll see you in a few minutes as this downloads. Oh, it's already downloaded. All right. So now it's going to reboot. You can just stay on this page. If you really want to, you can refresh it, but it does a pretty good job of updating it when it can connect to it again. All right. So we're back here now. It's only been a couple minutes here, maybe five. And it'll bring us right back to the asset list. And we can see that we have now upgraded. If we want, we can also upgrade the switch, but I'm not gonna do that right now. All right, I hope that was helpful for you. It's a pretty normal thing to have to do an upgrade. They make it pretty easy. If you're logging into it regularly, you'll see that. For any upgrade, I really do recommend looking at the release notes. Even if that's just skimming over the entire thing to look at the sections that are applicable to you, I've heard too many stories about people making an upgrade and then being surprised about the changes that happen from one release to another. Make sure you know what's going on with a device as you make an upgrade, especially something as critical as a firewall. We'll see you next time.